Please be seated. Welcome, family, staff, and our class of 2020. 4 p.m. I've been waiting for you guys all day. I know what's coming. Well, welcome. My name is Chad Barks, and I'm the proud principal of the best high school in all of Oregon. And I welcome you to beautiful Olympic Stadium and Sprague High School for our 48th annual graduation commencement here at Sprague Olympian and with the class of 2020. At this time, would everyone please rise for the playing of our national anthem, recorded by our own Sprague Choir. Our flag is hanging down on the south end next to the track shed.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. I would like to thank Capital Community Media, Alpha Sound, and Salem Kaiser Facility staff for their help in making this ceremony as excellent as possible. It is an honor to introduce some distinguished guests we have who are fortunate to be with us on stage and off to the side here. Our student-elected faculty speaker for today's commencement is a very, very recent retiree, matter of fact, within the last 3 weeks, and a beloved member of our English faculty. She has given the last 21 years of her life to Sprague High School as a teacher, and before that, 11 years at McKay. Most recently here at Sprague, she was focusing her talents on assisting our seniors in English 12. Please help me in welcoming Miss Kristen Anderson. Our school board representative up here with me behind is our Dr. Satya Chandragiri. Please welcome him. As well as Assistant Superintendent Ethan Udosanada. Each year, this work becomes increasingly more difficult and challenging, and of course, this year was no exception. It takes a team to plan graduation, and at this time, I would like to thank our assistant principals, Jesse Clayton, Mark Harris, Clinton Gertenrich, and Mickey Toft, as well as office manager Amber Reeves, for assisting with this graduation. Thank you guys for all you do. Finally, my last introduction is of our parents and guardians. So graduates, we didn't practice this yesterday, but you're gonna do fine. If you guys, graduates, will please stand and turn and face the bleachers. If you are a parent or guardian of a 2020 graduate, can you please stand at this time? Graduates, please give your families a big round of applause. Thank you all very much for all you have done. We've enjoyed our time together. We could not have done it, and they would not be here without you. You guys can be seated. And now my brief message to our Olympian class of 2020. Thank you all for your feedback that you wanted to meet face-to-face for graduation. This absolutely has been a treat today. So I know it is hot, we will be brief, we will be to the point. It has been an interesting end to your guys' high school experience. one that will certainly go down in history. While we can never replace the traditional senior year events, prom, Oli Luau, senior banquet, Miss Anderson will do a nice job here in a second of giving you a prom-like experience. So when she asks you, please follow along and dance. I want you to know how valuable you are as a class and offer these words as you officially leave Sprague High School to pursue your dreams. Salem-Keizer Public School's vision is this, that all students graduate and are prepared for a successful life. By being here today, you have hit the mark for the first part of that mission, and I congratulate you. With that being said, your journey has truly just begun. They say that all endings lead to new beginnings. So please value your high school experience and use it to propel you towards your new goals. Remember that you will always be able to say that you graduated from Sprague High School. For me, I appreciate the way this class, the class of 220, took charge during this year to make a meaningful experience and earn college credits when we weren't in school. Congratulations to the 61 seniors who earned college credits through Chemeketa this spring. Also, congrats to this class for raising over $2 million in college scholarships as you have and prepare for what is to come in college next year. Taking action in life, refusing to be passive, knowing what you want and planning for it, planning to achieve will lead you to be productive members of our society. Thanks, class of 2020, for speaking up over the last 4 years and advocating for change within our school. After spending the last 4 years with you, I'm confident you will make us proud well into the future. Thank you for your hard efforts. I'd like to remind you of a saying that is dear to me. It's your attitude, they say, not your aptitude, that will determine your altitude. Essentially, your mindset will determine your outcome, not just your ability level. I believe you as graduates can succeed and overcome challenges that will come in your life if you have a positive attitude about the future and your goals. Being a Sprague graduate means celebrating the traits and attitudes that got you here in the first place. Dedication, professionalism, determination, a desire to finish what you started, having a growth mindset, focusing on servant leadership, and most importantly, having a sense of humor. I challenge you to leave a mark on those around you, to continue to grow in your learning and find ways to connect in a positive way and use the traits you've learned here while at Sprague to achieve your hopes and dreams. Class of 2020, you are now deemed prepared for a successful life. I believe in you. Those on the stage believe in you. Those up in the stands believe in you. We all see that you have extraordinary gifts to offer those in your life. Sprague Olympians truly are the best of the best, and it is your time to go do something with your talents and make a positive impact in our world. It has been an honor to call myself your principal, and I will miss you and wish you guys nothing but the best. Thank you. All right, we're gonna get this rocking. Miss Anderson will come up to the podium, and she will deliver her commencement speech called A Hot Mess.
Welcome, seniors, family, and friends to our long overdue graduation ceremony for the Sprague Class of 2020. It is fantastic to see your beautiful faces today. It's been a while, and you've been missed. Seniors, let's just call it what it is. You were a hot mess when you walked in as freshmen, and you're a hot mess today. We're all a hot mess. Even chemo over there is a hot mess. But here you are, finally receiving your diploma, only to go out into a chaotic world of uncertainty, but with an opportunity to create change. We have some firsts and lasts that we share together. You are the first class to graduate during a pandemic. This is my first graduation speech and my last. You are the first and only class to have two proms in the same year. You are the first class to complete your high school experience online, and I am closing my teaching career online. You are the first class with the longest senior skip day. And my senior skip days are just beginning. You are special. I have loved teaching my seniors, joking with you, teasing you, and learning about your daily adventures. Our classroom mantra, what are they going to do? Fire me? Will always be a favorite saying of mine. I did not go into education to be separated from you and talk to you through a computer screen. I teach because I care about your future, and I am proud of your resilience, your gift, your grit, your care for others, and your love of reading. You know I had to say that, my seniors. You have endless and immeasurable potential. So follow your dreams, take risks, and be courageous in your future endeavors. Teaching has taught me to not judge a book by its cover. Take the time to listen to my students' stories. My essays can always wait to be marked up. To get to know parents, take the time to be present when you come in to chat with me and laugh with my students, and don't be afraid to show my vulnerable side, share joy, tears, and hugs with you. What did I like about online learning? One thing, the staff meetings. Here's why. When you go into an online learning staff meeting, your microphone should be turned off, and your camera should be turned off, because P. Barks, my own little P. Diddy, is going to give us a slew of instructions from ODE, from himself, from the superintendent, and I guess from probably some of you parents telling us, how do we go forward? Here's the great thing. He can't hear us. He can't see us. So we get to make comments, make faces accordingly. So we might say things like, has he lost his ever-loving mind? Is he crazy? Are we really going to do this? However, some people, I don't know, it might be someone like Chemo, forget to turn off their cameras or their microphones. So we've seen some really interesting ongoings at home from staff members during staff meetings. I will just let that sit with you and your imagination. And those of you who are teachers out there in other buildings, you know what I'm talking about. All right, let's wrap up with a family meeting. Communication is the key to success. We don't always like the hard conversations, but they must be done. Life goes on. Yes, even during a pandemic, protests, unemployment, riots, and chaos. Life as we know it right now is a hot mess. What can you do to make the world a better place? Create positive change. Go out and do something good for others and for yourselves. When you stumble, get back up. Don't stay down. Pick your fanny up and move forward. Persevere, stick it out. Fight for your rights. It's time to unite and look out for one another. Because when you make a difference in others' lives, you will see a monumental impact on your own life. You each have a plethora of gifts to share with those in your circle and those outside of your circle. So do it. Love instead of hate. When injustice arises and when violence overtakes our community and overrides your world, answer the call and seek to be the change for a better world. Be a positive role model. Create your tribe to be inspirational, optimistic, and progressive. Do you want a better world? Stand up, speak out, and vote. The staff at Sprague have missed you. Online learning is tough. It takes discipline and independence, but forge ahead. Whether you are moving on to college, a trade school, an apprenticeship, the military, or working, do it well. Give 100% of your soul and dedicate this next chapter in your life to excellence in all you do. Don't settle for anything less. Stay vigilant, stay strong. Know it's okay to be emotional, to cry, to reach out and ask for help. And it's okay to change your plan. Use the grit and resilience you have to progress to an amazing life, full of amazing adventures, traveling, friendships, love, but always, and I mean always, keep your family close to your heart. You are worthy of a life that is valued, respected, and successful. You cannot stay a hot mess forever. So get out of the hot mess we are in, and let's try to fix it. Never hate, live in peace. Love yourself, and don't forget, put a tortilla underneath your taco so that when you have a soft taco from all the stuff that falls out of your taco, then you have a soft taco. I actually learned that this summer. I did not know that, and I want to share that with you seniors. Do you understand? Good heavens, what is happening to you? Seniors, stand up, please. I just need you on your feet for a moment, because y'all are killing me right now with being in the 95-degree weather, I realize. Okay, so you didn't get to have a prom this year, so we're going to give you a 30-second dance prom dance. Oh, yeah. Oh, don't tell me no.
Shuffley shuffle.
Right? Did you just shake your head at me and say no? No, I don't think so. All right, hit it. All right, let's move it. Let's see you go. You got 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Here we go. Right, y'all are boring. Let's go, man. Move it. Here we go, Selena.
Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch.
He Bark said y'all were fun, but he lied. All right. Sit down. Like I said, y'all are a hot mess. It is my pleasure now to introduce to you one of your seniors, Miss Hannah Lee, who will be sharing her speech entitled Home.
Good luck, sister. You're going to need it with this one.
Thank you. Greetings, parents, faculty, and 2020 graduates. So this is the year that we've been waiting for. It's finally 2020. While it wasn't quite the flying cars that we had expected to be written in the next American pageant, it's crazy to think that some high schooler in the graduating class of 2050 will probably be sitting in the library 30 years from now, struggling to answer an FRQ asking to identify the social, political, and economic impacts on this crazy thing called a global pandemic. My name is Hannah Lee, and I am honored to be here today to see a healthy crowd as we celebrate in my 100% unbiased opinion, an unprecedented class that Sprague has ever seen, the class of 2020. On September 6, 2016, we walked through the orange doors of a building with practically no windows. As freshmen, we had too many expectations about high school that Sprague did not live up to. Nothing could top the BO specific to Sprague homecoming in the upper gym. We could only pretend to know the words to the fight song as we chanted, something, 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 our colors high, and we had the privilege in being the pit of the school. When sophomore year rolled around, it was time that we felt like real high schoolers, having retired from the weight that came with the title of freshman. This was obvious. We flailed our car lanyards left and right as we were finally allowed to leave campus for lunch. So excited that I almost made it look believable as if we had actually never left campus during lunch or something. Junior year can be summed up by a line that Burleson once told me when I was crying about my lack of ability to understand conic sections in room 6. Never cry about math, she said. There are a lot better things to cry about. We would wake up to the stars still out in a pitch black sky, racing to make the 7:28 mark, and eventually losing that race. We sacrificed who knows how many hours of sleep to balance standardized testing, state testing, AP testing, school, sports, hobbies, and work. It wasn't easy, but at least we had those who stuck it through with us. Shout out to SparkNotes, APNotes.com, CliffNotes, Slater, and Wikipedia. They say that senior year flies by. 4 years later, there was still nothing that could top the BO specific to Sprague homecoming in the upper gym, except this time there was a clear star of the night that dominated the dance floor, the one and only wrestling light. Somehow already, the first were turning into lasts. Last unexcused absence call, last blackout game in the Oregon rain, last time hustling past the librarian so they don't ask you to sign in, last time the bookkeeper telling you that you have to pay after school or during lunch and not passing time or class time, last time attempting to park in visitors until you see Robin in her golf cart. Just when we were finally going to star in the finale season of the high school movie that we had fantasized about our whole lives, the script got cut short on Friday the 13th back in March. And this got me thinking. We always seem to be seeking for an ending of fulfillment that we forget to live in the present. We think that, oh, we'll finally be content at 10:35 when lunch starts. We'll finally be content when we're out of Salem. We'll finally be content when we buy a Tesla. It goes on and on. We get so caught up in fantasizing about being done and moving on that we forget this moment right now is exactly what we've been dreaming of our whole lives. So I ask you to stop searching for completion and focus on what's in front of you. You probably have noticed some time while driving through Sprague's extremely efficient traffic system that the building has Home of the Olympians painted at the top. It's something that we pride ourselves here for, but it's much more than some paint on a building. What makes a house a home is a family, and by family, we grow. Something that Mrs. Magalia always rants about are letter grades. It quantitatively measures knowledge and is an inaccurate measure of learning. It leads students to prioritize a percentage over the process. In the world that we live in today, it's so easy to perceive every little thing from a lens of competition. But the truth is that life is always resetting itself. You never know when the dice will land you on do not pass go or do not collect $200. The point is that there is no ribbon to be cut at the finish line. I'm sure you all still remember the story of the tortoise and the hare. They say that the moral of the story is slow and steady wins the race. But the truth is that the hare had already lost before even beginning the race. If a hare only races against tortoises its whole life, sure it might have the ability to cross that finish line first every single time, but it also loses against itself every single time. On the other hand, the tortoise is growing every single day simply by racing a hare because it is also racing itself from the day before. That's winning and that's growth. Realistically speaking, it's not going to go smoothly. I still vividly remember the week before Thanksgiving break during freshman year, I was hit by this phenomenon called procrastination. When I finally brought myself to Mr. Trammell's desk, hoping for an extension on a paper, water filled my eyes until it could no longer linger. And you know what he said? All he had to say was, "Hannah, are you Chicken Little?" And naturally, as any freshman that clearly was not thriving under the stress of high school finals for the first time, I kept crying. He then went on, "Is the sky falling?" "The sky will never fall," he continued. "The sky will never fall." These words will stick with me for the rest of my life. For each one of us sitting on this field today, there are going to be countless times that the sky feels like it has already collapsed. But during those times, I encourage you to think logically. The sky won't fall, whatever the situation may be, whether it's our fault or not. We have complete control over how we choose to react. We can always take responsibility. Today, sitting in the crowd, we have our parents and guardians who have shown us the purest form of patience, guidance, and unconditional love. And to the teachers and staff, while we are sitting here thinking that 7:28 is an inhumane time to start school, and you are the ones who arrive way before that mark and stay long past 2:20 p.m. just so that people like me, who have a lot of missing assignments and makeup tests, can be sitting here today. People like you who choose to dedicate your lives to providing an education for people like me. For that itself, on behalf of the class of 2020, I want to say thank you. On September 6, 2016, we walked through the orange doors of a building with practically no windows. Today, we are walking out as different people, people who have learned. We are the first class to ever claim the title of Spirit Week Champions in Sprague history. We are the class that put the age-old tradition of the neon dance in the grave forever. We are the class that doesn't hesitate to speak our minds, but we are also the class that knows how to get down on the dance floor. This hill on Kugler Boulevard is way too small for us, 2020. Let's take everything that we have learned here in this family, here in Ole Nation, out there to every corner of the world that we choose to call home. Thank you.
All right, I realized you guys have the sun in your eyes, so, and you're hot. Let's get to some presentation. Will the two dignitaries please join me at the podium to present the diplomas? At this time, I attest that all members of the class of 2020 sitting before us have met all graduation requirements as determined by Salem-Keizer Public Schools and the Oregon Department of Education. Our class-selected reader for today at 4 o'clock is Mr. Kimo Mahi, if he'd join us at the microphone. Valedictorians and salutatorians will be noted as students' names are read. Okay, here we go. Will the class of 2020 please come forward to receive your diplomas?
Kyle Hinchcliffe. Olivia Jones. Emma Brammer. Alexi Gall. Ruger Vinecki. Cooper Stan. Chiara Martinelli. Carissa Marsh. Brody LaFountain. Jackson Hildebrand. Andrew Rogers. Brock McMullen. Sydney Shavitz. Ashley Margraves. Jackie Curtis. Jordan Hoops. Tiana Schreiber. Tyler Yates. Jordan West. Samantha Breen. Sprague High School 2020 valedictorian, Bridget Smith. Madison Shalansoff. Caitlin Evenson. Cassidy Jenkins. Ileana Skorniak. Janine Randall. Peanut Salinas. Grayson Salinas. Kobe Withers. Eisen Short. Edgar Perez. Wiley Roberts. Olivia Wyckoff. Kenzie Sturgeon. Paige Nichols. Alexis Barnwell. Olivia Denning. Reese Sherwood. Ashley Wilkinson. Emma Canellis. Ethan Fleming. Carter Hickam. Jackson Kansky. Sierra Hoffman. L. Donofrio.
All right, congratulations, class of 2020. just a couple reminders. You guys will, when we're done here, exit out through the stadium here. Across the street is your diplomas and your yearbooks. And if you haven't purchased one, there will be some for purchase. In a moment here, we're going to have Hannah Lee come back up. We will do our turning the tassel. But families, I want you guys to know, we have about 10 to 15 minutes that you guys are going to be welcome to come down onto the turf, take pictures. We do have another ceremony after this we'll need to do some cleaning for. But please feel free after the turning the tassel to come down. And if we need you to exit, we will make an announcement about that. There is a senior party tonight at 9 o'clock at CFC. If you guys don't know where that's at, it's on State Street. So I just want to make sure you guys are aware. There's probably additional information as you exit here as well. And once again, if you came in a vehicle, which most of you I'm sure did, if you could exit out the back gate, that would be perfect. All right, graduates, at this time, if you will now stand. Okay, I'd like to have Hannah Lee come back up for our turning of the tassel.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We have made it. Please join me in turning the tassel from the right side of the hat to the left side, signifying that we are graduates of Sprague High School. Thank you all for being here, and our 2020 commencement has concluded.
Support for Capital Community Media's Salem-Keizer Schools High School graduations is provided by Les Schwab Tire Centers, where doing the right thing matters. Experience the Les Schwab difference at your neighborhood Les Schwab Tire Center, or visit us on the web at leschwab.com. And by Salem Health Hospitals and Clinics. Also sponsored by Salem Auto Body and Paint Works, experts at getting you back on the road and repairing RVs, boats, semis, and power equipment. Phone 503-378-7595 or online at salemautobody.net. Thank you.